Hello, Internet. Playing Starbound again, just bringing some resources back. Okay, so I'm bringing some resources back. Kind of destroyed my diamond pick and have nearly destroyed a silver pick. And I don't even want to start on my copper pick because it's getting to be pretty slow. So I filled most of these chests. I got all this stuff here that I plan on using in particular rooms. This is just kind of generic stuff. Some items. More items. And more items. So I'm just gonna... Well, I suppose I should take them down with me, shouldn't I? Let's see. I'm gonna take this one first. There we go. Quick way of picking everything up. And we'll head down to the planet here. Should be right next to my place. Yep. Now, I don't know if I've mentioned this in the first video or not, but I've noticed that up here isn't loaded. So, or at least it wasn't before. Let's find out if it does it anymore. The rain is coming out in a different direction than it always used to. It used to go from right to left slightly. Now it's coming left to right. But what I was noticing in the past, maybe something's changed. Oh, no. There, see? Over here, see the raindrops hitting on the soft brick, the white-colored brick up there? And clearly there's no roof there, right? I mean, where I have a leak in the roof. But let's go check this out. And I do. I have stuff there. Because I didn't want monsters getting in and or the rain getting in. Because I was... The rain kept falling down and it would flow across the floor as water does in this game, which is awesome. But it would pour off this edge and knock all my oil lanterns down from either side. And I kept finding all my lanterns and lamps and torches down, and I couldn't figure out what was going on. And that seemed to be the cause, so I put that up there, thinking that would stop it. And then I came in here, and I must have been doing something, looking through, checking out some of the headgear or something. And I noticed the same thing happened. And I ran up here to see if maybe something broke the surface of the roof, and or the temporary roof. And no, it didn't. And then I just kind of toyed around for a little while, and I realized that if I go low enough, the rain starts falling. And I don't know why it's not doing it in the middle anymore, but that's fine with me. That's certainly fine with me. So I guess I'm just gonna start a new chest. I probably have 20 of these blocks already in other chests, but I want... Well, I guess these aren't going to go in the tomb, so I won't put those in there. These might not all go in the tomb either, but... did I bring the bone? Not yet. Okay. I guess I can leave the platform in there. And... Let's see. Got a lot of junk now. Gotta get some of this stuff put down. Actually get to work on it. But before I do that, I do want to... Yeah, see? Look at this. Not every time, but a lot of the times I come out here, I've got to fix this. Put it back up. Darn kids! Stay out of my lawn! Yeah. Alright, so... I think it's the water, but that's why I put it on this elevated platform that looks silly. It's because I wanted to make sure that water wasn't falling down and then flowing into it. I mean, close the door. That'll stop the water, right? I don't know. I guess I can't have nice things. So, I'm gonna go check on the back one now. Sure there's no kids back here.
Whoa!
They are definitely kids back there. Hey, go away, kids! Oh, I broke my door. Can't believe that door fell off that easily. I think that's where it was. I don't know. Doesn't matter. Go away! There! I didn't see it, but I look over. Now it's down. You can see water. It's dripping. But it's pooling in here. It's not hitting up there. So why is it... Look at even the way the water... The water's falling. It's not even... This happened while I was building my place, too. Get out of my house. Get out. Get out of my house. Spare a few of them. All these furnaces, I had iron smelting in them, I had gold, I had all kinds of stuff in them, and this wasn't here, this brick here, this had extended all the way, and when it started raining, before all this was built, the rain worked its way over and must have washed them all down, and I didn't realize it. I was off doing something else, probably building the rest of this area. I came back, all this had despawned. Nothing was left. The whole mining trip was gone. All the furnaces were gone. Not cool. So, rain has become my enemy on this planet. The hail doesn't even bother me anymore, but the rain definitely does. yeah, see, look, here's another thing. I have to constantly... I feel like a maintenance guy rather than some interstellar warrior. Constantly fixing these little problems around this place. Joys of home ownership. So, yeah, I'm gonna start filling this stuff up. I think I'm gonna start putting all the avian and temple related things up there. So I can stop carrying them around everywhere and storing them down here. Only remember where they went. None. These wooden spikes. These killed me so many times. I have no idea how, too. They were around a couple glitch houses I found. They were. I don't know, it was like some bone planet. The ground was all. Skulls and bones and things, and anyway, I'd step on these even with full health and walking towards them, not jumping on them, just walking by them. I thought maybe they wouldn't hurt me when I walked through them, and 125 damage, basically. I don't know how that insta kills me because I have more health than that, but like right where is it? It's 135. I was at full health, I'd walk over those things and just dead. Yeah, and I think I got these from there. Yeah, the glitch weapon racks. Yeah. Probably because it's with the spikes. But, yeah. I wasn't too happy about that. I died a couple of times. I lost everything I made on that run, I lost. But, I've been noticing a few things about the game mechanics that... I might do a couple of tips and tutorials for people that are new to the game, because it would have been nice to know off the bat. Like, I had mentioned that sleeping in a tent didn't seem to affect your hunger. Well, apparently, I've noticed that sitting in chairs and, in general, activating these things do the same thing. Like, it won't go down. At least that it's in this current state of the game, it won't. So, that's definitely something to keep in mind. Where is my tomb? I had a tomb set aside. Ah, these. There we go, there's all the headstones and things. Okay. Let me take these out, because they may stack with the ones I put in here. I think some of them did. And then I know where I can put these iron, steel, and whatever other block I have. And I always do this. I get back to my base, and I start putting stuff away, and then I realize I should be smelting something while I'm doing that. So I don't know if they'll stay loaded this far away, though. I worry about it. So, we'll just do a few here. I'm gonna split these. Thought I missed one. These should be done soon, and then I can take them out and put the rest of some more in, actually. There we go. Okay. This should be done. I don't want to put that many in of the copper. But it's going to be a little bit, so I'll just come down here quick and grab all the rest of my spare ores that I've had after each of the smelting. Some iron. And it's an odd number, so if I throw one in there, that should end up even. Put that there. I have anything else that I need to... Oh, right there. And there. And okay. That's another spare iron. Almost done with this one. And that one will still be a little while, so I can put away spare ores again. Now, what am I gonna need? I'm not gonna keep the copper one. I think I'm gonna skip copper now and go straight to silvers. But I feel like that's gonna negatively impact my silver reserves here. Where are they? But I guess I have enough just to make a few pickaxes here and there. So, alright, I'll keep the silver I have. I'm gonna put away the copper, though. Platinum. Am I gonna need that? Yes, because I'm gonna be... No, because I'm gonna upgrade that to gold, not platinum. So, platinum can be put away. There's some more copper, I think. Did I have a... I don't know why I didn't catch that. Smelt! Okay. And nothing, nothing. Good, got them all out. Now, put away these copper. I'm gonna keep the gold out, keep the silver out, and I don't need the iron. Going pretty good on the iron. Even better than the copper. I've noticed, as one of the tips I'll be showing, a good way to get the iron, lots of it anyway. So, stay tuned for that. So, let's see. I put away the diamond one already, because there's nothing you can do with it. Want a gold pickaxe. Craft that, and a silver pickaxe. I want to upgrade it straight to gold. I do. Okay. I got two of the same pick now instead of these screwy ones that don't match. like I said, I was hoping to fill these up, and I'm sure that I'm gonna discover. Well, I don't know if I'm sure, but I'm hoping I'm gonna discover new ores and things. I got my fine sand because I can actually throw it in there to make glass. Got the cobble. I don't know why I'm storing the cobble up here, because you actually use the bench down there to make the block, not the smelting stuff. But whatever. I got my copper, my iron, silver, gold, platinum, and diamond, but these are all empty chests up here. They were intended to be overflow for these, but at this point, man, I've raided solar systems and come back with that. So this refinery, I don't know when I'm going to get to the point where I feel, yeah, I can throw away ore and get money out of it. And also, forgot about this. I'm going to be making this castle theme is not going to be the only thing, because, I mean, I'd miss out on a lot of the game if I did just roll in the hay. If I did just the castle here, I'd miss out on a lot of the high-tech stuff, which I also find cool. Basically, this game has a lot of what I like. Like right here, this table's, I would consider high-tech, obviously. I don't think I have much of it down here yet. No. It's basically all up in my ship. I should bring that down too, just to make room in my ship. But I feel a little bit overwhelmed with the amount of stuff I've hoarded so far. Kind of want to keep it to just castle stuff around here. There's what I'm looking for. Stuff it in there with the rest of the chests. Oh, there's the hail. Good old hail. Actually had some fine sand laying around at one point, and the hail damaged it to the point where it broke it. It was kind of cool. I like that it actually damaged the blocks that it was contacting when it lands. So yeah, all the rest of the stuff that I'm going to need is backups at the ship. Yeah, I'll set up stairs. Long flight of stairs. So, did I get enough stuff out of my inventory? That's kind of cool. I'm just gonna toss it in one of these. I'll find them eventually. So, back up to the ship. Should bring the whole thing. Oh man. Well, this is not. This Gothic arch can go down there. These roof tiles aren't necessarily. Consoles or more. I guess I could bring all of it, and I'll just stuff it in it again. I'll just stuff it in a chest down there. So there we go. And there we go. Can't see. Okay. Good thing I wasn't in a boss fight or something. There used to be some semblance of order up here. Not anymore. This looks familiar. Barred door. Alright, first, even though it is not a low technology item, I've been keeping all my musical stuff in here. And I'm gonna go upstairs, and everything related to avian culture, insofar as these masks and pedestals and sarcophagus masks. I'm gonna try to keep together here. These I've got somewhere else. Do I really have 8 of those? Wow. Or does that say 3? It's 8. Not the console, that's This is cool. I like the fancy gum. I might replace this gum with a fancier version. There we go. I'm going to bring this downstairs because I still have one down there. And those two. This can stay, but... Alright, yeah, sure. And everything else, all the gray stuff especially, can go downstairs. Wait, sounds different? I like that noise better. Huh. Maybe I should keep both. I don't like them next to each other, though. Ooh, here's an idea. I planned on having benches in here facing this podium area, but I kind of like this too. Makes the room, gives the room a little more depth rather than just left to right, which I tend to do. I don't know if you notice, like, everything seems more or less left to right rather than front to back, which is hard to do in a 2D game, but to me, this looks like it's further back in the room. But this looks like left to right. So, there's that. Okay. I know some of these should just plop right in here. These avian tombs, I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to use them. So let's see, we got... Oh, these are different. Iron bar door and bar door. Okay. Fair enough. I don't need the avian hero. I do not want the bunny statue. Unstable, I have. Add that. I'm gonna put that in there now. That's new, really? Oh, the words honor a fallen avian. That's why I don't have it in there. So I want this to be more of a generic place than avian. So, that can go. That can go there. I don't know. But then I'm going to be using these. Plain avian stone tomb. I don't know. Maybe I'll use them. Maybe I'm a gigantic hypocrite. I don't know. We'll find out later. An open avian tomb, it smells. What's... Oh. Okay. Metal bars. I suppose that could be low tech too, so. Oh, this stuff has that in it. It's gonna be. I'm gonna try to make like my throne room area out of this type of material. Oh, maybe stone brick. Give me that. That's cool. And those are, there's your barred doors, good. Bones. There's the chest. Yeah, I'm sure I have doubled up versions of something. But at this point... Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Wait, floodlights. That can go in there. Stupid bunny thing. Oh, the graffiti's awesome. So is that. These are more high-tech type thing though. Could go here, I'll leave it here. Some of the books. And the roofing tile. I guess I'll leave that here. Okay, let's go. Pop some stuff in here. Not gonna fit. Will now. Oops. There we go. Okay. And I will be right back.